Ciao a tutti, ben ritrovati nel mio canale. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Allora, come va oggi? State bene? If you know how to respond, write your answer in the comments down below. But if you're not sure what I'm asking, check out the last video and you'll be caught up in no time.
Lasciatemi cantare, sono un italiano.
Today, we're going to talk about traveling and some useful expressions you definitely need when you're traveling to Italy. Okay, for this first example, let's pretend we're at the airport in Rome and our flight to Palermo is scheduled for 2:15 p.m. At the check-in, when passing through either flight or border controls, you may hear: "Potrei avere il suo biglietto e un documento di riconoscimento, per favore?" And a good response is: "Certo, eccoli." Some other things they may ask to inspect: la valigia, il bagaglio a mano, lo zaino, il passaporto, un biglietto andata e ritorno. So, make sure you remember these words to avoid any confusion or delays before your flight. Speaking of delays, make sure when you book, you give yourself plenty of time for any transfer that happens in Italy. There's been more than one occasion I had to stay in airport accommodations in connecting cities because a flight coming from Italy arrived late. Here are some things you might want to ask after doing your check-in to find out when boarding starts.
Scusi, per che ora è previsto l'imbarco?
L'imbarco è previsto tra 40 minuti. To ask where your gate is.
Scusi, dov'è l'uscita del volo per Palermo delle 2:15?
È l'uscita a 7.
Ok.
The flight went well and we have arrived at our destination, Palermo, dove oggi splende il sole.
È la giornata perfetta per iniziare la nostra vacanza.
Alla stazione.
Buongiorno, potrei avere un biglietto per Agrigento, per favore?
E qua lei.
Scusi, quando parte il prossimo autobus per la stazione?
Mi dispiace, ma l'autobus è in ritardo di un'ora.
Quanto costa un biglietto solo andata?
9 euro, prego.
Quanto dura il viaggio?
2 ore.
Dove posso noleggiare una macchina? Mi serve per 2 settimane.
C'è un autonoleggio là di fronte. Some handy vocabulary for things you may be looking for or need in the city.
Dov'è il museo?
Dov'è il teatro?
Dov'è il supermercato?
Dov'è la stazione?
Dov'è l'aeroporto?
Dov'è l'ospedale?
Dov'è la farmacia?
Dov'è la stazione di polizia?
Dov'è il parco?
Dov'è il centro?
Dov'è la spiaggia?
If you want to rent a bike,
dove potrei noleggiare una bici?
If you decide you want to go to the theater,
a che ora comincia lo spettacolo?
Che spettacolo danno?
Dove posso comprare i biglietti?
If you're interested in visiting a museum,
a che ora apre il museo?
O a che ora chiude il museo? A very important note for you travelers coming from places where everything is open all day long, Italian shops are usually closed at lunchtime and reopen later in the afternoon. They usually open at 9 a.m. in the morning until 1 p.m. in the afternoon, and then they're closed until 4 and they reopen from 4 till about 8 p.m. However, many public offices close at lunchtime and they do not reopen until the next day.
Although public offices are closed early, many are still open on Saturdays until lunchtime, of course.
You might be wondering why such a big break in the middle of the day. There is a fascinating history about the particularities of Mezzogiorno, and I've added a link down below if you would like to find out more. Also, some places that are open on the weekend are closed on Mondays, so watch out for that. When you're in Italy, just do as Italians do. Do not try to fight the change of schedule. Just take advantage of it. Eat a big, beautiful lunch, have a glass of wine, or maybe two, and have a nap. Or, in Italian, fai un pisolino. Do you know other words for pisolino in Italian? We have at least a couple more. This would be this video's comment competition. This is the winner of last video's comment competition. Thank you for liking and subscribing. As a tourist, you'll most likely be spending your nights in a hotel, bed and breakfast, or vacation rental. As often happens in Italy, you might find yourself taking an unplanned tour, some place where you didn't make a booking in advance. So to make sure that doesn't happen, we'll cover how to call and book a room in my next video. To make sure you don't miss the next video or any others, please turn on the notifications by pressing the little bell. If you found this content helpful, please like the video and subscribe. If you have a quick question, leave a comment and I'll answer as best I can. If you'd like to go further into a specific concept or want to learn more, you can book a time with me at the link below.
Fatemi cantare, sono un italiano. Buongiorno Italia, gli spaghetti.
Ciao a tutti, alla prossima!